second super robot I sent. Compact 2.
It's your boy Zappa, King of the Giant Robots, and welcome back to Super Robot Wars Compact 2. Previously, our routes converge. The I can't play this because I didn't make a decision route, and the route that I guess everybody else is going to probably get. Daitan 3 is now here. Akira Hibiki and Raiden are now here. LPO Puru is here. And we discovered, by some mystery, if you were to just play Part 2 completely and utterly raw, which means you were unable to get any of the carryover from Part 1 secrets, you would get Combattler V? Which is weird, because Combattler V, like, sticks to the Gondor side the entire time. That is, like, one of your dudes that you have for Part 1. I'm guessing that Combattler V might be like a mercy reward for the sake of having something, since you don't get any secrets. In any case, we have 12 minutes to stop a colony. Above the Stardust Colony. Hold on, I need to set something up. Okay. The name of the stage. Unmei no Otoko Tachi, or better known in English, Men of Destiny. Alright, by the time we've arrived, the colony is no more than 12 minutes away from the limit intervention point, the point of no return, the point after which its crash can no longer be avoided. As expected, ZEON have a number of advanced units guarding the colony's path, including Gato and some mobile armor. No more threat of the GPO2. No. GPO3 force deployed. Send 10. Rue is not where she belongs. It's fine. Alright, that's a heal bot. Wait, you know what? You're on consideration. You're not. Duke. Excellent. You're gonna have to hold back. Hooroo! Let's go. Because it's the GPO-1. It's been a very good unit. And now, Char. Okay. Udo, okay. Okay. The Dongayo team is already gone. Got it. Noted. Okay. You know what? We already invested in you, so you get to go. There are none secrets to earn here. Yeah, stick with those who are reliable. I just forgot to... I forgot to put Rue back in the Methus. So we're down one hillbot for more offense. Where are... They are well spread. You look at the book. This one book makes it easier to see where they are. The other book makes it easier to see what reinforcements are... Or to reinforcements at all. Also, that's not even the right. Anyway... That's the... There it goes. Okay, yeah, it makes it pretty clear. Bright has disturbance but does not have great routes. Come on, I'm running out of time. Get your brain together. No great rouse here. It's okay. Okay for now. You know what? Here's what we're gonna do. Have multiple cases of disturbance. Focus on going forward on this first turn. Route splits are going to happen, so after the stage, and after this stage, I'm gonna reassess my equipment, who's getting the bench. Items. I didn't hear you at all. A fool! Dang it. Oh well. This turn gets no disturbance. Or... Thank you. That's not what I wanted! Very rude. I didn't realize that was the map weapon! Yeah, that map weapon, very cool. Just let them cluster up, just what two? Never mind a shape happening. You know, the gods forbid a shape occurs. I am certain a shape will occur. In any shape that fits inside of a map weapon radius, those are good shapes. Chunky. That's some Campbell's right there. Some beef. Meaty. What? Meaty attacks. When an opponent attacks you on your wake up so that their attack hits on the first active frame of your wake up. If you try to wake up pressing buttons, you're going to be in trouble as their attack will active first, thus lead to big damage combo and likely to knock down. Thank you, FGC. I cannot use Meaty in this game. Dang it! I'm sure I could find a way, but 'tis not the season. Thank you.
parried.
You gonna learn today. 720.
Oh.
What if the Age of Fatso? Didn't think so. It's fine. Not mad. Sometimes you just gotta learn. This is the Age of Parries. Heal up. Yet?
Nope.
Stop that. Why not? Press support. Nothing. No support. Have support. Boat is hurt badly. Okay, a break for me, but a moment for you. Way to come back to crunch. Well, that's rude. I guess that makes sense. they are in range. No, don't do that. Also Batman. Alright, excellent. Your turn. Game. Mashimer. Okay, you don't have a whole lot of AP. Put it. Damn guy, yo. Oh, that's not the map art. Ooh, okay, that's a lot wider than I thought. Alright then. Go Rocky. Multi-missile. Jesus! Oh! Oh, okay, if that's how that's gonna go. Odds of you hitting with this. Pretty bad. Do my intro? You can't do my intro. That hit. Duke. Got him. I didn't have that problem. What happened last Monday was the truck and the vent cleaning happened. Meshmire down. Judo level up.
Judo get top blood.
Support level one. Let's go. Kudu 2! Ikimasu! Well, you know Ariko is not happy about that shit. Oh, man. Ooh! I know we just barely got started, but I had a package get dropped off. I'll be right back. Alright, cool. Another model kit I don't have time for has appeared. Thank you. Really? No. Yeah, like, at least be honest that you want something. Ask for it. Okay, no. Let him know. Tell him. Don't be a cheap little thief. Don't be rude. Levels up. Support level 1. I forgot to unpause after casting the servants. I used a couple of devotions on Dankuga. Zytarn got a hit here. Parried the counter. Zambot got a hit here. Didn't even get hit back. You have to have a car that parts dealership on. Money? Exclusivity rights? Thank you. god, even hot-blooded, only 3,000 damage. Fuck you, game. Get wrecked. Now dodge it, excellent. Delete this woman. What did I say? I said delete. Wait a minute, what? Ah, I didn't save before. Ah. There it is. Down. Shinobu, level up. Whole team. Ryo learns love. Why? Masato, what? What are you? What? 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 Why? Why is that even a thing that you could learn? That's so dumb. Masato learned detonate. On turn five, Zeon's reinforcements appear, including Shima, now in the GPO2. Nuclear blast is everything we don't want to think about, especially given we've already wasted half our time trying to stop the colony drop. Judo, you're here to serve a function, and lagging the game is not it. This ain't it, dog. Come on, Judo! You know what? I'll take a shield. Boss. What did I say? No, I'm not getting nearly one shot. Dan Kuga! You could see that from a mile away, guys. Come on. Well, Bright says we have 7 minutes left. Kinda boned right now. And we sure are kinda boned right now. Come on, Judo, don't give up. Yeah, Judo, we're not boned. We must continue to fight for justice and the Earth.
Even Boss will do his part.
Oh-ho!
Let us bask in the song one more time. This is the last time we're going to hear Emissary from the Sky, I think. There's no need to despair. The Machine Robo team arrives on turn 6, having already defeated the Gandara party that was coming to support ZEON. Finally, welcome to Team Wrong Stall. Defense level 6, support level 2. I need to put some need to invest some limit. Ki, the shouting, focus, gain, Axel, mercy. Team Blue Jet. Defense level 6, support level 2. Axel, focus, scan, love, and inspiration. Welcome to Team Broad Drill. Support level 1. Great Guts, focus, flash, hot blood, and inspiration. Welcome to Team Triple Gym comes with Axel, Devotion, Gain, Wall, and Great Guts. Backseating. Well, oh, support level 5. Wow, okay, that's some support. Backseating is Reyna with Rouse, Great Rouse, Trust, Bless, and Focus. No, we're going in. By Kung Fu. Let's go. Give Rom a little bit of HP back. These two. That give Reyna enough. Yes, perfect. A great rouse for all. Alright. Heal everybody. On. Focus. Disturbance. Thank you. game. Come on. Why do you get worse by the day? Level up, support level 5. Deflected! Almost 50%! Good checkup, investigation. Don't be any more sick. Stop being sick. Levels up. New type level 5. Ah, when 10 or less enemies remain, even more foes appear. Let's see, on turn 5, the ZEON reinforcements appear with SEMA. Machine Robo shows up turn 6. Beware Atomic Bazooka. Gacha's morale raises fast. Beware. The enemies that are no match for machine robot units and should fall quickly before clearing the road for Gacha. Yeah. The plant-based life forms have appeared, and they are harassing Excellent. Anime. Well, take slash through the name of the stage is A Men of Destiny. Well, Destiny does have a few men in it, you know, a couple. Mostly same face syndrome, but as they say,
it do be like that though.
Well, let's see if these are enough first. Hey, there you go, Judo. Defense is fine. Nice. I need you to hit though. You know what? That's fair. Burn 7. Thank you. Oh, well, let's kill one more enemy first. How about that? About them apples. That's neat. Sheep as in herding the chats, right? Oh, I don't think I need to hit that hard. Oh yeah, cannot put triple gym there. Machine Robo. Isn't it though? Grill pleasure punch! Daniel, do you have enough for one more? Let's go, Daniel! I move. Hey, guess what? The new Zeon is worth money. Come on, Cold Rocky. I know this ain't Robot Wars 3, but I need you to do it! Look, the Vulcans are not here to help you, my man. Time for beam sabers. Donkey Kong 73, rebranded a couple months ago. Ko Uraki! Come on, lad! Making me sleepy with this shit, son. The cannon finisher. Levels up. Sun attack chaos mode. Thank you. Ah, you fool! You foolish fool! You attacked
Rom Stall.
Rom, please. Ruin this woman. Because Gato is in the museum? That's why? I think I can get the kill if she doesn't block it. Dang, you still blocked. Stop using your shield. Dima, come on, dog. I know I could do it if she would quit using her shield. Little weirdo. You know, levels up again. Of boss more. Boss has done, he has done some work in this game. I put him in Great Mazinger first stage and he did well. I got to use the Super Deluxe Ultra Delicious Fabulous Deluxe Morata Punch twice. The age of Fatso is compacto. YC-chan? The rock island.
Bright learns great rouse. Bright just got an arousing level up.
Thanks for being around. Thank you.
Guru levels up.
Level up. Daunt, alright. Love, alright. You know what? You can run it back. But hit up.
I took one more turn to crit up. Skills.
I'll give Rom the hit. Yeah. Attack! That's a different set of issues unto itself. Ooh, and learn Ki. Alright. After our third partition, we wrap up this stage. The other enemies, allegedly, according to the author, are no match for machine robot units, which did not touch anything because of spacing. They should fall quickly, clearing the road for Quattro and Coded made the colony alter its course. I don't know why them. In the meantime, Rom asks for an audience with Bright to discuss the Vyandana's objectives. Bonus item. Propellant Tank S, which is another case of data on the wiki, was swapped. Repair Kit S, Anti-Beam Coating, 1TK, and Accuracy, plus 20. Let us inaugurate the official joining of the Kronos crew. With her calling the drop averted, the situation on Earth calming down, Alankar judges this is the right time for the next step. Masha Marcello is to lead a new group of mobile suits against the Lon Nobel, while Glimmy Toll, already being sent to Jabro, destroys the Gondor team with help from the Titans. We already know he fails. I don't even remember if he shows up. I might have played them in such the right order that he didn't factor in, or I never got to touch him because he was too far away and runs away after some turn count. To Mashamar, the Titan's appearance is pretty surprising, but leaving the greedy Glummy unchecked is just plain worrisome. Turns out Haman has already accounted for this and knows what to expect for him. She considers this assignment a nice opportunity to see how he acts. How you gonna act, Glummy? Some of the Londo Mills thought the machine robot team members were covered in armor-shaped machines or something like that, but they're actually mechanical lifeform. If the Dongayo team had left in such a hurry, they could have told Bright what Rom is now telling about Gyandara to Unmuchan. Wait, what? I don't like how that's written. What Rom's telling now about Gyandara? Telling Bright that the Gyandara are probably searching for Mutron. And to be honest, I think this part of the conversation might be explaining the Gyandara and Mutron. And then this conversation is like, yo, y'all are actually machine life form. Y'all are not people. There are different sorts of machine life forms. The one that looks completely like machines, such as Blue Jet and Rod Drill. And then there are the ones that look more humanoid, such as Rom and Lena. I'll have to double check the subs on that one. Excellent is telling Akira about the only thing that she and Kyosuke actually have in common. Other than she wants to date the fuck out of him. I think that comes in time, though. There was an incident. The incident. During the time in officer school. A subtle accident from which only the two of them managed to survive. When Wayne walks in before Excellent gets to really tell what caused the incident. Which is Machine Robot's Lena, not Judo's sister. Not appearing in this game. Mysterious dialogue. Untranslated. Wright calls the Condor team to tell about ZEON landing on Earth. Because these were deployed immediately after the last battle, the Londo Bell couldn't intercept them. During the call, Hosky reveals that the Dongio team told him about the planned planet and bitches to Wright about the secrecy compromise. That Wright's secrecy compromised his ability to plan countermeasures against the eventual Earth invaders. Fair play. However, your plate's already full. We're not going to give you more food on your plate when it's full. Wright apologizes and transmits everything he has about the planetoid, but keeps on withholding information. They've just learned that the planet is picking up speed. As far as he knows, the only way to stop that thing is by shooting it with far more firepower than what we all can provide. The Titan's former headquarters group's 2 colony laser should still be functional. Rom imagines that the simultaneous Zeon and planet offenses are not by coincidence. With the colony crash averted, but the situation still confusing, this would be a great time to deliver a fatal blow to the Federation forces. For that same reason, the Bangar and the Gyandra may also attack the Earth's surface to find the Mutron. Perhaps confirming that theory, enemy troops start gathering at the gate of Zedon and Confei Island, while Von Braun reports having found a Vega Alliance army frontline base at the dark side of the moon. Next time. As much as I'm on and on and on about chapter in almost every episode, for real though, I'm going to keep saying it to mark where we are in the game. We begin the final chapter, Octal 6, the Earth Sphere Confusion chapter. Inside Frontier 1. Frontier 1 is where F91 occurs. The Gate of Zedon, Skull Moon, Inside Solomon, and the Group's 2 vicinities. Why I never did this before? These are the mysteries. There's no reason to not do them in order. Unfortunately, because we have Peru, we do not get Peru 2. That doesn't mean I'm not going to try, but my understanding is that they are mutually exclusive. Other than that, playing the stage last will get us another V-up unit. Skills and experience don't seem to carry over from game to game, but my grasp is that items do. So, we will nab that V-up unit. Next time, Hikaru Kaze no Kana, I think. I mean, those are the lyrics of the song. But let's go get Seabook and Sesame.